Is a T-Bone production coming to you live from Dubai. A live segment for Filipinos loaded with tips and insights. Standing out, speaking out. It's entertaining. It's informative. It's interactive. And we want you to be a part of it. Standing out, speaking out. And now, here's your host, Kabayan Rico, live from Dubai.
Why do you think people are hired for the job? Based on survey, these are the reasons why they are hired. They are related to the boss. That's one. They are back up with strong recommendation. Third, they impressed the interviewer. Fourth, they have strong personal brand presence. Next, is they are competent for the job. Yan ang maganda. And last, they are hired out of necessity. Kailangan talaga ng kumpanya, kahit maliit lang yung skill mo, but because of compliance, probably from the government, ay napilitan silang kunin ang isang tao. If you are looking for a job, join us for the next 1 hour and learn from our discussion on how to pass job interview. Magandang umaga sa lahat ng mga nanonood sa atin sa Middle East. Magandang hapon naman dyan sa Pilipinas, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. At umaga at gabi in other parts of the globe. Ito po ang inyong lingkod, Kabayan Rico. Nagbabalik sa ating Stand Out, Speaking Out. Brought to you by T-Bone Productions. Joining me today, kaya nga dapat talaga competent yung bisita natin to discuss, kasi dapat yung mga nanonood, lalo na yung 3.9 million followers of T-Bone, ay merong matutunan. HR manager po for, imagine, 18 years at active na active sa community, kasi meron silang HR organization. In fact, dapat naka-ready na ito. Kasi aalis ito bukas, papuntang Africa. Pero because of her commitment and dedication to share her knowledge to those who are watching us today, kaya andito. Oh, closely guarded ito ngayon. May escort talaga. I'd like to introduce to you, malaki ang sahod pa, no? Rhoda Colliano. Rod, bumati ka muna dyan sa mga nanonood sa atin. Jan.
Hello po sa lahat ng viewers natin, and I'm very happy to be with you today with Sir Rico, of course. And hopefully po yung ating discussions would help you, especially when you would like to be successful in your job interview. So, Sir Rico, happy birthday lang sa aking mom.
Uy, madam, happy birthday!
At sa aking pinsan na si Rona.
Kung malapit lang si madam, wala na. Pagkatapos ito, aatake na tayo doon. Oo, nasa Bulacan lang si madam eh.
Yes,
oo,
yes.
Siguro next time na bakasyon ko, no, pag nagkataon na birthday ni madam, aatake ako doon.
Sure.
Alam mo yung bisanggit ko kanina, Rod, no, na bakit na-hide yung mga tao? Katotohanan talaga yon, di ba?
Of course, Sir Rico.
Di ba? Katulad ng Yung unang binanggit ko, they are related to the boss, di ba? Oh,
cannot be helped.
Anak, di ba? Yes. Or you married the daughter of the owner, di ba? You married the son of the owner, oh, di ba? Eh, automatic manager yon. Pero ang problema yan, maging example tayo ng Peter's principle dyan.
Yes.
Kaya importante talaga. At saka yung pangalawa, back up by strong recommendations. Paano kung, lalo na sa Pilipinas, di ba? Kung ang mag-recommend sa'yo, governor, eh paano yan?
Wala na, hindi na kailangan na
senator. Oh, senator, di ba?
Correct.
Kaya, yun. Ang maganda talaga, you are hard because you are competent for the job, di ba? Maganda kasi, Rod, yung you are a perfect fit for the job. You're not a square peg in a round hole.
Correct, correct. Kumbaga, kaya, mas meaningful yung pagka-hire sa inyo.
Oo, di ba? Ikaw, you've been hiring people for 18 years.
Correct. No? And from all levels, support staff up to senior directors. So,
kaya, pakinggan nyo yung sasabihin niya ngayon, ha? Ha? Siya mismo ang living proof na ano yung na-experience niya na pagkakamali ng mga taong sumalang sa interview. Oh, stay where you are because magbabalik po kami with our discussion on how to pass job interview when we return.
Bini, bini lang pa kung paano nahulog sa'yo. Sinta, ikaw lang nagparamdam nito. Kaya sabihin mo sa akin ang tumatakbo sa isip mo. Kung mahal mo na rin ba ako, isayaw mo.
Doon tayo sa elegante, pero sulit. UAE Kabayan Souk.
Oy! Kung gusto niyong bumili ng mamahaling relo, no? Tatingin niyo, mahal, pero affordable yan. Sa UAE Kabayan Souk, I'd like to say hi to Mr. Amigo and Miss A. Oh, sila po yung may-ari ng UAE Kabayan Souk. Welcome back! Oh, Rod, ito na yung kuan, dapat nilang malaman, di ba? Kasi, like here in the United Arab Emirates, we Filipinos, I'm sure you will agree with me na kahit hindi ikaw yung nag-hire, kahit ibang lahi yung mag-hire, we Filipinos are given first priority, di ba? Because of our competency of the work. Pero ang problema talaga niyan is paano ka mapasalang sa interview kung yung CV mo ay, nako,
tama, kung poor your written po, di ba?
Kaya, normally, ano ang nakikita mo sa isang CV na nagpapa-turn off sa mag-i-interview? Hindi ka tatawagan, no? Anong nakikita mo sa CV?
Una po, gusto ko pong i-share sa mga ating mga kabayan na una, sinend nyo sa maling email.
Oh, yun.
Yan. Oh. So, syempre, hindi na namin yun matatanggap, di ba?
Oh.
So, importante po, when you look at the job advertisement, make sure you follow the instructions on saan isi-send. Kanino isi-send? Kasi po, like for example, lahat po ng tao nasa LinkedIn di ba? So, usually po yung mga recruiter, magpo-post sila ng job advertisement sa kanilang company page.
Company page.
And then, ilalagay po kung kaninong email isi-send.
Email address,
Ang challenge po is minsan, magko-comment yung aplikante, sasabihin, please check my profile.
Hindi pangit yun. Di ba? Ay, sa dami bang applicant, no? And, ikaw ba, in your 18 years in the field of human resource, umabot ba ng 500 yung applicants mo sa isang...
Sir Rico, thousands.
Thousands?
Yes. Oy,
nako, thousands daw. Paano yan? No?
So, yung doon po, for your CV to stand out, normally po at this stage kasi, we're already using technology
ATS.
To help us. Oh, yes,
ATS.
Yes, yes.
Applicant Tracking System.
Wow, alam mo, Rico.
May number tayo ng isang HR organization.
Very good. Very good. So, yes, the Applicant Tracking System. So, ano po yung ginagawa nito? So, let's say, for example, may job advertisement and then it attracted, let's say, 2,000 CVs.
Susta ko.
Of course, we would not have the time to check
paano yun, Rod? We are talking about more than 175 nationalities applying for the job.
Exactly. So, ang ATS po, ang gagawin niya is ipifilter out niya ang mga CVs. So, it's important that when you write your CVs, it is well-written and tailored.
Oh, tailored. Hindi generic, ha? Sabi niya, tailored.
Yes, exactly. And of course, when we say po well-written, I remember meron po tayong
yung last
about
time,
how to write a very good CV. Una, yung mga spelling mistakes, dapat po wala na yan.
I-proofread talaga.
Correct.
Pero meron namang halimbawa Microsoft Word. Diba? Spell check, no?
Tama po bago natin i-send. Pangalawa, pag po naglalagay tayo ng mga work experience, i-highlight po natin yung accomplishments.
Hindi yung duties and responsibilities. Nako, sawa na sila sa duties and responsibilities. Dapat yung nagawa mo sa kumpanya.
Tama. I-highlight po natin yun. Or, if you have special skills or knowledge, especially kung ano po, a requirement po yun dun sa trabaho, i-highlight po natin yan. And as well as, wag mo kakalimutan ang mga questions sa ATS, sa tinatanong po dun sa
ganoon
system.
Ganoon ba?
Yes.
So, paano yung, di ba dapat, kung tailored fit towards the position, dapat yung mga keywords ang...
Exactly po. Kasi the system can filter out and automatically disqualify the CVs even if hindi na namin kailangan tignan.
So, that means, halimbawa, customer service, cashier, di ba? Safety officer. So, dapat yung mga keywords pala is related to the job, di ba?
Exactly. Kaya kailangan po intindihin natin ano ang requirements ng trabaho and then we edit our CV to fit the requirements. Kasi lagi po nating tatandaan, ang trabaho naming recruiter is to find the best match for the job that we need in the company.
Just mahirap yan. Paano kung yung pool of applicants mo, sabi mo ay more than 1,000, madugo pala yung trabaho ng HR talaga.
Opo. And also, it would help then, Sir Rico, if you've got referees.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Kasi po, syempre, di ba ako pag sinabi ko na, ay, kakilala ko to, nakatrabaho ko na to, di ba?
So, back up, di ba?
Yes.
Oh, strong naman, back up.
Hindi rin po kayo i-recommend kung mapapahiya yung tao, di ba? So, if you do a research in the company sa dami ng kaibigan mo, di ba? Baka mamaya may kakilala ka pala doon. And it would give an extra boost po.
Okay.
If it's a referral. Yan. So,
ako, buti na lang nabanggit natin yon kasi dapat we need to let them know in advance na dapat yung CV natin, we need to do it perfectly.
Exactly po, exactly. So, like we said, dapat wala ng error or grammatical errors yan. Ngayon, may situation naman, Sir Rico, yung mga kabayan natin na medyo earlier in their career, nag-job hopping.
Ay!
Yan.
So, paano yun? Nakaka-apekta ba yung job hopping sa ATS?
Minsan, not necessarily po sa ATS, but on pero the manual. Person evaluating.
So during the manual evaluation of your CV, kasi
medyo questionable po yun. Like, why are we going to invest in this person, train this person, and then leave us for a few hundred dirhams, di ba? So, if that happened, of course, hindi na po natin mababago, di ba? What I would suggest you do is those jobs na nag-job hopping kayo, i-highlight talaga ang accomplishment. And then, later on, in your job summary, present what you can offer sa company po. So, it would help if you would create a very compelling cover letter.
Importante talaga yung cover letter. Pero, in your point of view as an HR practitioner, may negative effect yung job hopping? Ano ba normally pag makikita mo na job hopping, ano yung naiisip mo as an HR practitioner?
Actually, Sir Rico, when I speak to the line managers, the hiring managers, of course, because we work with them, di ba? Sila po yung talagang final hiring decision. We just give the recommendation. So, ang naiisip po nila sa mga job hoppers is walang commitment or loyalty sa company. Ah, okay. Yan po yung first impression.
Walang kuan pala, balingbing. Oo, kung ma-opera ng medyo malaki, oh, doon na naman tayo.
Lipat na naman.
Oh, lipat diba? Na naman.
And syempre po sa company, medyo negative yun. Kasi, kumbaga yung continuity eh. Diba? So, aalis na naman, aalis na naman.
Teka muna, Rod, batiin muna natin yung mga nanonood. No, kasi last week, ang daming nanonood sa atin. Eh, ipakita nga natin kung sino dyan ang nanonood sa atin ngayon. Gusto ko rin banggitin pala yung last week na nanonood sa atin. No, ang dami nila. No? I'd like to say hi to Lincoln Baloa, Mick DeHito, Marcelina Capriccio, Mary Jane Ifondo, Emmy Romero, Barangay Tanod, pati yung Barangay Chairman, nanonood nga eh.
Hello.
Jonalyn Ripolyes, Emma Plaza, Wendy Tarok, Samuel Buagayan, Joe Andrino, Enong Felix, Marwani Pataho, Jana Dimapilis, Simon Hantika, and marami pa. At yung mga nag-share din sa atin, no? Gusto kong pasalamatan yung sharer natin, Althea Milioso, Myra Gonzaga from Taiwan, Rodora Capuno from Italy, oh, Miles Dasa from the Philippines, Nisba Ulama from Saudi Arabia, Luzmin Salado from Cavite City, Agnes Ibarli, Lovely Rose Lagmay from Taiwan, Janet Esperanza from Abu Dhabi, Apple Brain from the Philippines, Elmer Lingad, Edwin Liadok, Diop Sabido, Nerissa Timtim na nag-celebrate ng kanyang birthday yesterday, and marami pa tayong pasalamatan, no? Stay where you are kasi magbabalik kami para ibahagi namin kung bakit ba talaga nag-submit ka na ng umabot na nga minsan 50 CVs, 50 companies, di ba? Pero walang tawag. Bakit? Malalaman natin yan when we return.
What's the true meaning of luxury anyway? It's not always about opulence. Or extravagance even. It's more about being able to revel in the finer things in life. Living well, you know? In a new world where space is of utmost importance, it's about comfort. Having peace of mind. Feeling secure about yourself and your surroundings. It's about having time. The nearness of you and everything else you might need. But more importantly, it's about being able to share it all with you. Lucema, the luxury of wellness and sustainability.
Yan ang company na magbibigay sa mga OFW ng pagkakataon to realize one of our dreams, magkaroon ng bahay. Artoland! We'd like to thank Bybit, Artoland Anchor, Kabayan, UAE Kabayan Sok, para kompleto ha, UAE Kabayan Sok, and King's Medical Center. Oh, back to our discussion. Oh, alam ko, maraming nanonood sa atin. Yung, kung pala, comment, ipakita natin para ipakita mo sa screen para naman matutuwa naman sila. Barangay Chairman, bakit po lahat na narinig ko at nababasa para magandang CV pero hindi pa rin nila tinanggap sa puso niya? Oh, narinig mo yung sagutin natin yan mamaya. But shout out watching from Iloilo. Oy, mga Ilonggo dyan, marunong ka ba mag-Ilonggo? Meron ka bang...
Ay, hindi po. Kapampangan ako.
Kapampangan ka pala.
Kabalin.
Hey, oh, proud mom of Roda Kulia. Yes. Si Madam is watching. Madam, happy birthday. Oh, ngayon, ilabas na lang natin yung mga comment chong habang nag-discuss tayo para makikita naman nila na, uy, yung name ko nag-appear sa screen. Oh, ano yung dahilan, Rod, na kahit ba umabot ka na ng 50, nag- kaya sa isang compound, di ba? O sa building lahat, binigyan mo ng CV. No? Ano yung mga reason bakit hindi ka natawag?
Well, una po, katulad nung earlier discussion natin, hindi nga okay yung pagkasulat ng CV. Pangalawa, syempre, reality po. Baka sobrang dami rin ang nag-apply, di ba? So, posibilidad din.
Posibilidad yun.
Yes. Tapos, ang isa pa po is, like I mentioned, you gave it to the wrong person.
Security guard yung binigyan mo. Di ba? Imbis na, minsan kasi may katamaran tayo eh, no? ayaw mong pumasok doon na meron lang receptionist, di ba?
Correct.
Why don't you walk in and ask the receptionist, sino ba ang tamang tao na tatanggap ng mga CB?
Exactly.
Eh, yung karamihan, kung nakita mo na yung security guard, oh, Moseng, pakibigay naman, wala. Trust ka, di ba?
Correct.
Anyway, sabihin ng guard na, it's not part of my job.
Correct.
Oh,
correct.
Paano kung yung security guard may disgruntled feeling towards the company? Traskan, di ba?
Hindi na po nagkaroon ng chance na makikip ng CV.
Oh, diba? Kahit gaano kakagaling, no?
Correct.
Oh,
correct.
Tama, ano pa?
Tapos, syempre po, nag-a-apply ka sa trabaho na hindi naman swak sa experience mo.
Ayun, oh. You are not fitted for the job. Para
correct.
Kang yung binanggit ko kanina, you are a square peg in a round hole, no?
Yes, correct.
Oh,
correct.
Kaya, dapat talaga, oh. At isa pa, no? Generic yung CV na binigay, di ba? Isa din yan, no?
Correct. So, dapat po talaga is intindihin natin ano bang hinahanap nila.
Oh.
And then, tayo, we sell ourselves by matching their requirements sa ano pong kaya nating i-offer.
Mm.
So, kailangan po i-highlight natin yon. Anong kayang gawin? Ano na ang nagawa? Which is yung accomplishments mo sa past experiences.
Oh.
And then, of course, importante din po dyan na dun sa pag-sell nyo sa sarili nyo, is talagang i-highlight nyo kung bakit kayo yung best suited for the job.
Mm.
So yan, talagang, kasi po yung CV, parang brochure yan ng restaurant, di ba? Na kumbaga, if it is not enticing enough, then they would not bother to call.
Kaya nga, yung sabi nga nila, the CV is like a billboard
exactly.
Of the applicant, di ba?
Correct, tama po yan. So kailangan, talagang well thought, tailored ang CV without error mistakes, without grammar mistakes, and then you should highlight your accomplishments, not just your tasks.
Nako, kung duties and responsibilities ang pag-uusapan natin, hahaba yan.
Totoo
diba?
Po.
Totoo.
So dapat po huwag copy-paste sa ating job description, di ba?
Oy, yan ang maraming guilty dyan.
Ay,
lalo na yung mga baguhan, copy-paste.
Totoo po yan, totoo. So iwasan po natin yung ganun. Kaya, kumbaga, because we will know, like for the recruiters, we would know if you're just keeping it, kumbaga same CV na sinasend sa iba't ibang kumpanya. And of course, always make sure po na it's updated. Kasi minsan, you might have updated it 2 years ago. And then madami ka nang nagawa in between. Hindi mo hinighlight. Sayang.
Ito, isa kang nanotice ko, Rod, lalo na sa mga baguhan, visit visa, no? They're not actually applying to a lot of companies, no? Pag magbigay lang ng 5 CV, okay na. Tapos maghintay na lang ng tawag, no? Hindi pwede yan.
Hindi po. Hindi po. Sabi nga nila, di ba, the more entries, the more chances of winning.
Di ba? Para kang kuhan dyan, MLM. Di ba? Oo. It's a game of numbers.
Pero totoo po yan. Totoo po yan. And why not leverage technology? You don't have these days mo, di ba? It would be a pity if aasa ka na lang sa face-to-face na pag-abot ng CV. Leverage technology. You've got a lot of job portals na nakaupo ka sa bahay mo and then you can apply to thousands of companies just by updating.
Instead of just trying to update your social media accounts.
Exactly. Exactly. Tama po yan. And of course, you must always present yourself in a sincere and honest manner. Hindi naman po pwede na masyado namang exaggerated yung CV natin, diba?
By the way, we'd like to say hi to another box of sharer. Sinaida Tadena, Adele Estrada, Ridbert Haisali, Joanna San Diego, Babe Sardinio Tan from Singapore, RG Domingo, Jeff Canyari, architect ito, Inday Sherrill from Abu Dhabi, Gigi Tatoy from Cebu, Mario Capon from the Philippines, Oliviana from CDO, and Fatima Mendoza from Abu Dhabi. At lahat po ng 3.9 na million followers ng T-Bone. So let's continue. Ano pa ron para sa'yo?
Siyempre po, let's say for example, nagawa nyo na, no? So the best na yung CV yun, everything. Of course, the key is also to prepare well. Pagmamaya, tumawag na sa Rico, diba? So, tatawag na sa'yo ang hiring manager or whoever in HR and then they would invite you for an interview. Now, this is your chance as well to really showcase and kumbaga, makita nila na kung ano po yung sinulat nyo sa CV is totoo nga. So, ito na yung kailangan nyo din paghandaan, yung yung interview stage.
Ah, mamo. Ikaw, no, sa trabaho mo, no, sigurado ako naka-experience ka na nito. Do you also monitor the social media accounts of applicants?
Well, personally po ako, I look at the LinkedIn.
LinkedIn.
And then, here's a trivia for you as well. So, ang ating pong ATS, ang ating applicant tracking system, okay, it actually has the capability of fetching your social media accounts,
yeah,
if you set your setting to public.
Oh.
So, you are allowing us to peek into your social media accounts with your permission. So be careful also on how you present yourself or how you brand yourself in social media, because that can definitely affect your the impression that company
it's
will have.
It's actually a double-edged sword, di ba?
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, kasi kung maganda yung pinakita mo sa social media, that's an edge for you.
Correct.
Pero
correct.
Halimbawa, no, nag-apply ka as a secretary doon sa, halimbawa, may vacancy yung St. Mary's Church, di ba? Yung kumbinto,
yes,
no, nag-apply ka sa secretary, tapos nakita doon sa FB mo na palagi kang nagsasayaw, no, nasa bar ka na, let's get loud,
disconnect ko, diba? So, ano na, next candidate na
next
tayo.
Candidate na.
Yes.
Yan ang problema. Meron akong, I need your opinion on this. Ito bang gaps on employment sa CV is a valid reason na hindi mo na tawagan ng empleyado? What would be your impression kung merong gaps on employment?
Well, if the candidate is really, kumbaga po yung profile really interests me, I will take the time to call and validate.
Okay.
But if I am swamped with thousands of CVs, I would not bother. So, importante po, let's say for example, for personal reasons, nagkaroon kayo ng gap sa inyong CV, it's okay, but indicate it. Para po hindi naghuhula ang recruiter.
Okay.
So let's say for example, Sir Rico, there was a year, like for myself, to as an example, there was a time po na I had to care for a family member, my grandmother.
Yeah.
And that was a year that I was out of work. So I can indicate that personal reasons.
Okay.
Pero syempre po, let's say for example, someone like you have more than 20 years of experience sa work. I would recommend din naman po na huwag nyo nang masyadong i-expound yung masyado ng matagal. Yes.
Yun.
So, highlight
so,
the...
So, more or less, in your opinion, ilang years? Like, let's backtrack. How many years na pwedeng i-include on sa CV?
Siyempre, tignan nyo muna po yung job ad. Pag sinabi, at least 10 years of experience.
Yun, pwede
so,
yun.
Yes, you need to expound on the last 10 to 15 years para po makita nila. But if they say that 5 years of related experience, then you can just highlight that. And then the other, kumbaga po yung other experiences nyo, medyo summary na lang. Para wag naman po maging novela na yung inyong CV, diba? We will not have the time to
And speaking
that.
Of CV, no? What do you suggest, yung length ng CV? Hanggang 2 pages lang ba ngayon or even longer?
Well, a good rule of thumb po is between 2 to 3 pages.
Okay.
That should be more than enough to sell yourself, especially if you've got, you know, longer experience. And of course, there would be exemptions, Sir Rico. Let's say, for example, interior designers. Diba? So of course, they would have their portfolio, which they can present naman po as an electronic copy. But in general, yung pinaka-core CV mo, 2 to 3 pages should be a good indicator. Yan.
Pero ito, importante ba na magkaroon tayo ng referral sa ating CV?
It helps po. It helps. And why not give it? Bakit mo pa i-withheld? Minsan may question din ako noon. Like for example, references upon request.
Ah, okay.
Bakit? Secret ba yun? Bakit hindi mo lang ibigay, di ba? I mean, let's make the recruiter's job a lot easier, di ba? I mean, if it's not, kung hindi naman siguro CIA agent yung referral mo, di ba? Why not put it out there? Kasi it would save their time din po. So, it would help na ilagay nyo na lang. Or, if you don't want to put any, then don't put a reference to it at all.
Okay. Yeah. By the way, for those who are watching us, yung lahat po na nanonood, kung may katanungan kayo, mag-comment. Barangay Chairman, paki-comment nga kasi mahirap nang ibalik yung kwan mo. Yung tanong mo kanina, Barangay Chairman, mag-comment ka uli, no? I'd like to thank another batch of sharer, no? Chris Namukatkat, Leng Exclamador, the Donna Doyon, Raquel Mayo, Dodge Pitakti, Ivy Grace Aguilar, Mimi Leones, Elvira Simpron, Tiopanes Quintala, Manuel Balistoy, Judeline Paho, Nympha Syed, Wilsey Atasan, Nico Atasan, Aileen Danoco, and Emma Solano Abbas. Thank you for sharing last week's podcast natin, no, na kasama si Chris Diamond. Yung comment ni Barangay Chairman, no, ilabas mo nga, baka binalik na niya, no? Well done, Sis Roda. Oh, si Edwin Dorian. Sis Edwin Dorian. Si Paul's Middle East ang mayaman.
Yes.
Oh, Don Edwin Doria is watching. Oh, nako, bihira lang niya manonood, no?
Another distinguished Filipino.
Oh, of course, Dubai. Mayaman yan. Alam mo ba na tuwing may event ako sa Philippine Consulate every December, no? Siya mismong tatawag. Ano ba ang maitutulong ko? Diyan talaga, no? Edwin Doria with a heart, no? Paying it forward, di ba?
Yes.
Teka muna, malapit na pala yung Independence Day, no?
Yes.
We'd like to invite those who are watching us, join us on June 12 at the Dubai World Trade Center. Lalong dumami ang artista, no? Dalawa lang yung nauuna eh. Ngayon, kasali pa si Piolo Pascual.
Ooh.
Oo. At si Kim Molina at yung Jowa, kasali, no? So, you have all the reasons to join us, oh, June 12 at the Dubai World Trade Center. I'd like to say hi to Miss Josie Conlu of Red and Beryl. Naku, pumayat na siya ngayon. Naku, wala na nga siyang time magka-jowa, no? Dahil sa event. In fact, she's now 10 kilos lighter.
Wow.
Oh, busy. Mamaya may press con pala yung PID 124th celebration of the Philippine Independence. Believe talaga ako dyan si Josie Conlu of Red and Beryl. Pasalamatan ko ulit. Direct Mike Nerfuel for creating this podcast, standing out, speaking out, para marami naman tayo matulungan. Oh, yes. Si Barangay Chairman, bumalik na ba yung tanong niya kanina? Yung nagpadala na, pero ano yun, wala sa puso ata yung si Barangay. They are always with us. Oh, ito na, Barangay Chairman, bakit po lahat nang naririnig ko at nababasa para sa magandang CV, pero hindi pa rin niya tinanggap sa puso niya? Anong, how do you interpret that? No, Rod, anong...
Kumbaga, ginawa na niya po lahat para maging okay yung CV niya, di ba?
Oh.
Kaso parang hindi pa rin siya natawagan. Hindi pa rin inaccept yung kanyang application.
Oo. Oh. Dapat, huwag kayong aalis para malaman nyo, no? Stay where you are dahil magbabalik kami para to discuss the common mistakes.
Yes.
Guilty ang mga job seekers. Guilty din ako when I came here. No, wala kasi nag-advise sa akin eh, no? Kaya stay where you are. Kung gusto nyong magkaroon ng trabaho, if you wanna ace job interviews, never move a muscle. We will be right back in a little while.
Bini-bini lang pa kung paano nahulog sa'yo. Naramdaman lang bigla ng puso. Aking sinta, ikaw lang nagparamdam. Sabihin mo sa akin ang tumatakbo sa isip mo. Kung mahal mo na rin ba ako, isayaw mo ako sa gitna.
Doon tayo sa elegante pero sulit. UAE Kabayan Souk.
Anong nakaraan?
Yan! Oo! magandang pagkakataon para makapagregalo kayo ng relo para sa mahal niyo sa buhay, mother-in-law, girlfriend, boyfriend, husband, wife. Visit the page of UAE Kabayan Suk. Mr. A, si Miss A at Mr. Amigo. Oh, remember that para i-message niyo at bigyan kayo ng discount, di ba? UAE Kabayan Suk. Back to our discussion, Rod, no? Ngayon, nabanggit na natin yung mga dahilan kung bakit hindi natawagan. Pero ito na naman ngayon, no? Ano yung pagkakamali na naka-schedule na ng tawag, ha? No? Lalo na yung iba na late, dumating. Oh. So, we will tackle the first one, no? Kasi ang isa sa mistake daw is arriving early or arriving late. Ano ba talaga yung tamang oras?
Napakagandang tanong po niya na, no? Siyempre, no-no po talaga ang arriving late.
Okay.
And of course, hindi naman po natin maalis na may mga...
traffic!
Or may mga reasons po na hindi maiiwasan.
Okay.
But I would recommend, call the whoever called you, the hiring manager,
or
kung sino tumawag sa interview, and tell them, let's say for example, 15 minutes in advance, kung feeling nyo malilate na kayo, inform them. There's nothing wrong with that. Ang masama po is, walang niha niho, and
yan.
Then they would arrive very late.
Ay, pero early naman. So, ilan bang minutes talaga ang ideal for you to arrive?
10 minutes po is the best.
Okay, yeah. 10 minutes. Tararin nyo, ha? Yeah. 10 minutes before your interview schedule. Dapat.
Yes, opo. Eh, kung 15 to 10 minutes yan. Yung, magandang oy, ano po yan.
Nakaka-experience ka na ba na nag-reason na late dahil traffic?
Opo, at medyo turn off ako doon.
Of course naman! Eh, it boils down to the attitude of a person, di ba?
Exactly.
Walang disiplina kasi, halimbawa, no, bukas meron kang schedule sa Six Side Road, no? Dapat a day before, tinignan mo na, nag-bus ka na or nag-metro ka na just to check yung travel time.
Exactly.
No? Para you can estimate yung travel time mo. At hindi ka malilate, no? Dapat
true.
Yung talaga ang gagawin.
Tama po. And I really am impressed with applicants who actually take the time to research kung paano puntahan yung interview site. Kasi nakarinig na po ako ng ganyan eh.
Yung iba, no?
Yes.
Pero karamihan talaga, go with the flow.
Yeah. Oh. So huwag po tayong malilate. That's important. Mm. And then, pag too early naman po kasi, it bothers naman yung magre-receive sa inyo.
Mm.
So, that's a good indicator. 10 to 15 minutes, it's great. Kasi it allows them to prepare as well, their office or wherever you will have the interview.
Oh, okay.
But too early po, medyo parang annoying din eh.
Let's say, one hour. Para man, desperate ka naman talaga.
or nakaka-disrupt din po siya, di ba?
Di ba?
At saka po, ang isa pa ding dahilan why we space sometimes yung timings is because there are other applicants.
Uh-oh.
And of course, hindi rin po kasi maganda na makita mo pa silang lahat doon, di ba? Baka mamaya manervyos ka pa. So, mas maganda po yun. 10 to 15 minutes, that's a great indicator in arriving to a job interview. And of course, no-no po talaga yung being late. Yeah.
Ang ikaw ba ay sa 18 years mo, nahalata mo ba sa isang job applicant na hindi prepared?
I'm for sure. Yes.
Paano
sir,
malalaman yan na hindi siya prepared?
Well, una po, makikita mo na yan sa body language eh.
Okay.
Tapos pangalawa, yung pagdadamit, Sir Rico.
Oh.
Yan. So if you don't come smartly dressed, so it tells me that hindi ka nag-prepare, first of all. So, yun yung pong impression sa akin.
Mm.
Pangalawa is yung body language.
Okay.
Yung hindi po sila confident.
Mm.
Yung masyadong nag-fidget. O kaya ang likot-likot
ng... Diba, hawak pa ng phone.
Ayan.
Diba? Nasa interview ka nun, hawak mo pa yung phone.
Correct. Ano, tapos po, pag nagtatanong, hindi agad makasagot or yung hindi niya po makompose yung sarili.
Okay.
And the interesting thing is, yung interview po is about the applicant, di ba? So, kung hindi mo pa ma-sell yung sarili mo, paano na, di ba? So, ano po, halata talaga pagka
interview talaga
mo na hindi prepared yung interviewer.
So, importante interviewer talaga na preparasyon.
Yes. At marami pong ways para mag prepare. Mm. Una po, like what we said, yung timing, di ba? Oh. Alamin po natin, saan ba talaga tayo pupunta na lugar? Mm. Or, right now, online interviews as ano din po yan eh, nangyayari na over Zoom. Or, so, kailangan alam po natin yung link, di ba? At saka yung tamang oras.
Mm.
Pangalawa, make sure that you know the dress code for the company.
Okay.
And usually po ang sinasabi natin is, it's either you dress according to the
one step dress higher code or with the post that you are applying.
Exactly,
right?
But never down.
Oh. Yeah. At saka, dapat isipin nyo palagi, ang interview ay hindi fashion show.
Correct. Ibagay po natin siya dun sa company, di ba? So, example, Sir Rico, yung company is business attire talaga.
Oh.
Tapos dating ka doon na para kang K-pop star, ay, diba?
Huwag ka naman magsuot ng ganito kung business, nag-a-apply ka ng like sales and marketing executive tapos exactly. Ganito ang suot mo ay hindi pwede yan.
Kasama po yun sa packaging ng isang aplikante kasi it tells the person kasi first impressions po, first 30 seconds, they form in their mind a certain impression of you. So make sure that you arrive on time, dress appropriately, and then know the contents of your CV. Kasi, syempre po, di ba?
Paano kung copy-paste?
Eh di magbabakel-bakel ka pag tumasagot.
Yan ang problema.
Correct. Oh,
at saka hindi mo nga, yung work experience mo, hindi mo alam yung chronological order.
Exactly po, yan. So, importante po na alam niyo yun lahat. And especially kung ano yung sinulat nyo sa CV nyo, dapat
panindigan.
Exactly. Oh. So tama yun. Dapat honest ang yung declaration sa CV. As well as, i-recall mo yun. Especially if your years of experience is more than 10 years.
Mm.
So balikan ang CV.
Mm.
Alamin, dito sa kumpanyang ito, ito yung nagawa ko.
Mm.
Ito yung nagawa ko. Nang sa ganon, pag tinanong tayo ng interviewer, we can answer confidently because you're just recalling memories from your past experience.
Yan. We will continue. Batiin. Salamatan ko muna yung mga nag-share last week. Donia Marlin Kemp from Canada. Keith Canalita from Spain. Joselito Bautista from Greece. Uncle Joe from Agusan del Sur. J-Boy Tupas from Saudi Arabia. Mexico, Berzola from Kuwait, Neil Galloy from Saudi Arabia, Doc Ronnie Molina, ito yung father ni Kim Molina from Saudi Arabia, Phil Pops, Art Lumantas from Qatar, Bobby Iro from Qatar, RJ McClung from Canada, Rizaldi McClung from Canada as well, Nene Herudias from Israel, Roy Sinining from Saudi Arabia, Joy Lor from Korea, and Emma Bendejo from Butuan City. No? Marami talagang nagsishare sa atin, no? And their effort of sharing is helping really our cause of, trying to share knowledge to those who are watching us. Let's continue. Kasi kanina, importante ba? Paano mahuli? No? Para naman mabigyan natin sila ng tulong, Rod, no? Research. Importante yon, di ba?
Yes, tama po yan. It gives a good impression if you know the company in advance.
Mm.
Yan. So let's say, for example, una po yan sa mga tinatanong ko eh. What do you know about our company?
Mm.
Yan. Kasi gusto ko po makita kung interesado ka ba talaga sa kumpanya namin, di ba? And I am impressed with candidates who actually tell me exactly who we are as a company. Kahit naman po yung overview lang, like what we do, ano sa ang bansa na operate.
Ano yung mga activities ninyo?
Sino yung mga common clients?
Sino yung competition?
Exactly.
Importante din yun.
Yes. So yun, it gives a good impression po sa recruiter kasi it shows na interesado.
Oh, interesado ka talaga?
Yes. Tama po. Mm. And then, usually po, next na, yung mga tinatanong pa po namin is, so, madali po kasi mahuli, like you said, Sir Rico, kung unprepared yung like for me, I don't settle with yes or no questions. Mm. So, madalas po probing questions talaga kami. So, kailangan, kabisado mo yung CV mo in and out.
Mm.
Because we can spot someone who is lying or exaggerating.
Probing questions. Ano ang sample ng isang probing questions para maintindihan nila, Ron?
Sure. So, let's say, Sir Rico, ang requirement is kailangan merong 2 years experience sa food industry.
Okay.
Face-to-face with customers.
Okay.
Yan. Tapos, sasabihin, pwedeng itanong ko, so have you, do you have experience face-to-face dealing with clients in a restaurant setting? Sabihin niya, yes. Sasabihin ko, okay, can you give me a situation where you faced a difficult customer with an kumbaga walang basihan yung complaint.
Okay.
So how did you deal with it?
Mm.
Medyo mahirap po magsinungaling sa ganyan kasi situational.
You will just let your imagination run wild. Ito ang mahirap niyan. So, wala. Blanco ka rin. No? Kasi nagsisinungaling ka eh.
Tama po. So let's say for example, nagawan mo ng paraan yun. Gumawa ka ng scenario.
Scenario.
And then the recruiter would naturally be curious to ask, what was the complaint about? O di mag-iisip ka na naman na kasinungaling.
Paano kung yung blanco ka, di ba? Wala kang focus, so mahuhuli ka talaga.
Tama.
Yun ang kuhan,
yes.
If you're watching us live today, please paki-share naman para maibahagi natin ang learning sa mga nanonood. Tingnan natin kung sino ang babatiin natin, ipakita natin yung mga hello Ate Rhonda. Ayan si Charisse Eusebio. Kilala mo ba?
Pinsan ko 'yan.
Ay sino pa? Nanonood ang T-Bone from Bicol po, Virgie. Ipakita na lang natin yung mga nag-comment siyang para matutuwa naman sila na uy, yung name ko nakikita ko sa screen. Si Maya Nicolas, si Almari Aguanta is ang dami natin. Ang ganda talaga ng T-Bone. Of course, T-Bone na 'yan. Stay where you are. Magbabalik po kami with more learnings after this break.
Bini, bini, lang pa kung paano nahulog sa'yo. Naramdaman lang bigla ng puso. Aking sinta, ikaw lang nagparamdam. Sabihin mo sa akin ang tumatakbo sa isip mo. Kung mahal mo na rin ba ako, gisayaw mo ako sa gitna ng...
Doon tayo sa elegante pero sulit. UAE Cabayan Su.
Dito na tayo sa elegante pero sulit UAE Cabayan Suk. Hi Mr. Amigo and Miss A. Back to our discussion. I'd like to thank Bybit, Arthurland, Ancore Rewards at King's Medical. Maraming salamat for believing and for supporting T-Bone. Paki-follow naman ng page, kung hindi pa kayo naka-follow ng page ng T-Bone. Paki-follow po. Follow also yung page ko, Tatak Pinoy, Loud and Proud. Paki-follow din po. Welcome back to our discussion. Ngayon, ito, nature ito sa kwan, lalo na pag yung mga disgruntled employees, no? Trusting the old boss, old company. Anong masasabi mo niyan, Rod?
Alam niyo po, pwede niyo namang sabihin, especially pag tinanong kasi Sir Rico, ano bang dahilan ng pag-alis mo sa iyong kumpanya? So let's say for example, ang taglagang dahilan ay yung amo, di ba?
Amo.
Pwede mo namang sabihin 'yon in a very diplomatic way.
Sample paano? Okay, how would you handle it?
Okay, so let's say for example po, recently lang to. And I appreciate how this person answered the question. So I asked, what was your reason leaving the company knowing that you've been there 9 years? So of course, naturally, I'm curious. And then this person, he's a senior IT director. Mm. And the way he answered me really impressed me. And he said that on my 7th year, the management changed.
Okay.
And then I was then transferred to a different line manager who did not share the same views and did not align with my values.
Maganda yun.
Yes. So it just means that hindi na po sila, kumbaga, it's not good to continue with the working relationship because it's not healthy. Mm. And that's a valid reason.
Oh, maganda yun. Yun ang, like for example, no, kung halimbawa, hindi naman natanggal yung gano'n. Kwan yun eh. Ang problema kasi niyan, he is considered a threat to the other guy, di ba?
Yun
ang sample ng kasi yung mga management kasi they have a lot of resources or styles, yes, in coping up with a problem, like yung tinatawag na Dilbert's principle, di ba? Minsan kasi pag yung supervisor na nakaka-apekta sa performance ng tao, pinopromote nila in other departments, no, so that the employees can excel, no?
Yes,
yan,
yes,
ang Dilbert's principle, no. So ito, ano pa yung with your kung ikaw HR, no, ikaw yung nag-interview, Rod. Ano ang impression mo sa tao na ninira, no?
Syempre po, it's not
he would
good.
Also do the same.
Exactly. At saka po, let's always remember that, you know, yung sinasabi po natin na ano ba yun, yung 6-degree separation.
Oh, yan.
So, kung if you talk bad about your boss, you'll never know na later on, baka mamaya magkita ulit kayo, tapos baka mamaya boss
baka
mo na naman
siya. Baka matransfer na naman siya doon, na pirate,
exactly,
di ba? So, paano yan?
Exactly. So, hindi
don't
po siya
burn bridges.
Exactly. Oh. So, hindi po maganda impression yun for a hiring person. Kasi, it just shows that you cannot handle such differences in a personal manner.
Mm.
Kasi you don't have to rat out or, you know, kumbaga sabi nga nila eh, ilabas mo yung baho nung dati mong boss.
Oh.
You can still say it, but in a professional and diplomatic manner.
Mm.
Like yung sa example po na sinabi ko. Kasi hindi po maganda because it shows that you could be a toxic person.
Oh, exactly.
So, parang ako, as a recruiter, I would not recommend you to proceed with the hiring process.
Baka ikaw pa yung magdadala ng kuan doon.
Negativity.
No, negativity sa workplace.
Exactly.
No? Paano yun, Rod, na halimbawa, no, sa isang kwan, company, no? Pag nagtataka ka, no? Sigurado, kasi tinignan mo na yung CV, no? Feel na feel mo talaga na matatanggap ka. Pero you are disappointed kasi hindi ka tinanggap. Iba yung tinanggap, no? Yun pala, no, hindi mo na stress doon sa CV mo yung competency at strength mo. So ano ang pwede mong advice?
Well,
para maiwasan 'yan.
Yes, so during the interview po, it's your chance na eh, face to face na kayo eh. So might as well pag tinatanong kayo, listen carefully. And then when you answer the interviewer's questions, make sure that you highlight your strengths. And if asked for weakness, ito pa, Sir Rico, because sometimes may mga interviewer talaga, they would ask, what would you consider your areas for improvement or your weaknesses? So don't shy away from these questions because it also gives the recruiter the impression of how you, kumbaga pa, anong ginagawa mo to develop your areas of improvement. So make sure po na when you answer the questions, you answer it in a direct way as well as making sure that you highlight yung ano ba yung mai-offer mo sa company. That way, mas makikita po nila, like I said, balikan po natin yung goal ng recruiter, like us in HR. We want to find the best match, di ba? So, make sure that you highlight your accomplishments talaga, tsaka yung strengths mo, and extra skills if you have, that will be beneficial for the job that you are applying for.
Mm. Yes. Narinig nyo, di ba? Iba talaga pag yung bisita natin, competent in the real sense of the word. Marami tayong natutunan, no? Kaya sigurado ako yung mga nanonood dyan na merong interview schedule this week, magpapasalamat talaga kayo kay Roda Colliado, yung HR manager. O, alis na ito bukas, pero dapat nag-iimpakip ito. But because of her commitment to share her expertise, kaya ito nandito. Oh, 8:30, nauna pa sa akin. O, may kasalanan tayong dalawa. Hindi mo binati si Madam Seni, yung HR group mo, anak ko.
Yes, so the United Filipino HR Professionals, yan, kila Ma'am Zen, kila Ma'am Monette, yan sila Sir Oliver.
Oy!
Hello po!
Umayat na si Monique.
Yes, yes, yes.
Umayat
yes.
na.
Very impressive po, diba?
Nag-diet.
And of course, Phil HR din. Ayan.
Hello, Phil HR. Sina Sugar.
Yan, si Mitch Robby.
Si Cathy.
Yes.
Oh, naku, si Robby Mayaman. Kaya tawag ko sa kanya, Madam. Madam Robby, madaming pera.
Hello, hello po. Ayan.
Pero bilib ako sa'yo. No? Yung ibang group, hindi bumabati sa kung ano, ibang group. Pero ikaw, bumabati ka.
Member ako eh. So, hello po sa inyo lahat.
Stay where you are. Magbabalik po kami for the tricky job interview questions when we return.
What's the true meaning of luxury anyway? It's not always about opulence. Or extravagance even. It's more about being able to revel in the finer things in life. Living well, you know? In a new world where space is of utmost importance, it's about comfort. Having peace of mind, feeling secure about yourself and your surroundings. It's about having time. The nearness of you and everything else you might need. But more importantly, it's about being able to share it all with you. Lucema, the luxury of wellness and sustainability.
Thank you for staying. Sana po marami kayong natutunan, lalo na yung mga job seekers dyan. You're watching Standing Out, Speaking Out, brought to you by T-Bone Production. Direk Mike Nerpio, thank you for creating this live podcast. Gusto kong pasalamatan yung iba pa nag-share last week, no? Joy Narvasa, Rose Tolentino, Ana Serdania, Pinky Pesquera, Ana Mariano, and April Wenceslao, Jana Ligaspi, Jing Chandria, Jeril Gaid, yung una, 3 weeks ago na bisita natin, Choki Itchocera, Sandra Casey, Romer Tisado, July Avila, Jessica Miranda, Isagani Isguera, Dennis Alejandria ng FI at Johnny Daly and Dailinda Ramirez. Now, back to our discussion. Ito na yung madugo, no? Kasi dito talaga sumablay ang mga Pinoy. Ito yung dahilan kung bakit nag-exit ako 7 times.
Anong nangyari sa Rico?
Do you have a UAE experience? Oh. Eh, galing ako ng Saipan. Pagdating ko dito, wala eh. Nung time na yon kasi, paglalaki nag-apply, sabi na, do you have a UAE experience? No? Pag babae, diretso hired. No? During that time kasi, ang babae kasi for them is madaling kuhan, magtrabaho, matuto, no? Teachable. No? Ano ba? Ano ang tamang sagot pag yan ang tanong?
Ayan,
para so, sa mga baguhan, makinig.
Ayan. So, very tricky po yan, especially if it is very specific to the region yung gusto nilang i-hire. Mm. Ngayon, total nandun ka na sa interview, di ba? Might as well answer it smartly.
Okay.
So, paano kung wala kang UAE experience? Paano mo sasagutin? Well, highlight a parallel experience. So, let's say, for example po, like kami, galing din kaming Kuwait. So, it's a similar environment. Mm. So, you can emphasize or highlight that it's similar to UAE. Nang sa ganun po, makita nila na, okay, we will consider.
Mm.
Or, let's say for example, zero. Mm. Zero UAE experience. Then, relate it to your past employment. Mm. Probably in a different country, pero same setting or same industry. So, kumbaga, i-divert nyo po yung focus from the UAE to the experience.
Mm.
Nang sa ganun po, you'll still have a fair chance.
Yun. Narinig nyo, mga baguhan! Oh, pwede bang halimbawa sasagutin mo na in another way, Rod? Let me know if kung pwede ba ito, ha. Halimbawa na while looking at the job responsibilities enumerated in your ad, these are the tasks that I did in the past back there in the Philippines. And if you are concerned about the clients that we have, I also deal with people from different walks of life, different nationalities as well. So for me, the only difference between the UAE experience and my experience in the Philippines is just the geographical location.
Hard ka na sa Rico.
Pwede bang ganon?
Perfect po yan. Yan yung perfect example ng sinabi natin wherein you highlight the experience, diba? And you put it very nicely kasi okay. You are convincing the hiring manager that location does not matter.
Yan. One down. One tricky question down. Ito ang madugo, no? Tell me about yourself. Paano?
Parang Miss Universe question po, yeah, diba? Yes, napakahirap niyan sagutin sa totoo lang, Sir Rico. But what I would suggest as a general rule of thumb
okay,
is...
Okay, sige. Formula. Gumawa ka na lang. I-share mo yung formula kung anong dapat talaga.
So, have in mind... And maganda po mag-practice. Diba? Mm. Mag-practice. So, have in mind a 2 to 3 minutes maximum introduction of yourself.
Parang elevator pitch.
Exactly. Oh. Exactly, Sir Rico. So, normally, we would like you to share with us yung konting education background. Hindi mo naman kailangan i-enlist lahat ha? Baka mamaya ano-ano na yung
diplomo
mo.
Exactly. Pati mga dance lesson dyan, isari mo pa.
Huwag na, diba? Huwag ng mga master trainer. So, relevant to the job.
Relevant to the job. Ah, ulitin ko, relevant to the job.
Yes.
Hindi pwede then, yung mga passion show, mga gig, hindi pwede yun.
Tama. Mm. So a little bit of your educational background. Okay. And then a summary po nung iyong work experience.
Mm.
So a brief summary. So it's like what you put in a career summary.
Okay.
And then of course, I would suggest na towards the end, kung ano yung what you are passionate about.
Mm.
So that they have an idea of what kind of a person you are na nag-a-apply sa kumpanya.
Mm.
So huwag naman yung masyadong formal na nag-aral ako sa ganito kadami ang experience ko. Give them a feeler of who you are as a person and what type of personality you have.
Okay.
Ayan. So yan po yung magandang pasimula pag ang tanong is, tell me about yourself. Kasi sa totoo lang po yung mga hiring manager, yan yung pinaka parang automatic nilang question.
No,
diba?
Automatic talaga.
And it can go a lot of different ways. And this, I call this gateway questions.
Mm.
So, ito po yung magbidikta ko yung ano yung flow ng inyong interview eh.
Mm.
Especially if the interviewer is not very experienced.
Mm.
So, might as well set the proper tone pag sinagot mo tong tanong to. Yan.
Napakaswerte ka. I'll cite an example, Rod, no? Kasi I'm into the field of safety several years back. So, napakaswerte ng isang safety officer kung ang mag-interview is HR na baguhan na walang alam sa safety kaysa
correct.
Safety manager ang mag-interview. Kasi doon ka talaga mayayari, di ba?
Correct.
You can lie, no? Kasi pag sabihin mo lang, importante kasi sa safety, especially baguhan ka, even without NIBOS, IOS, or other, you know, OSHA, or any compliance certificate. Kung alam mo lang yung, you memorize the terms by heart, hindi ka na mag-iisip na you know the difference between an accident and an incident, you know, hazard and risk, wala, diritso na. No, doon ka, pwede ka pang magkuhan yan, yung impression, but may alam ito, kahit yung basic terms lang pala.
Correct. So, yun, talagang, sabi nyo nga po, elevator pitch. You set the tone and you set it very confidently and strongly. Nang sa ganun, it gives them a great impression of you. Yeah.
So, pwede bang kasali na yung accomplishment mo dyan sa 3 minutes mo?
Baka po masyado na matagal yon. So, just give them a glimpse pagdating dun sa summary. Kung gusto nyo po i-highlight yung experience nyo, choose 1 or 2. And then mention, and then connect it po doon sa what drives you as a professional.
So, halimbawa, like safety officer, I'm a safety practitioner who attended more than 100 training seminars and responsible for reducing the accident by 40%.
Yan, maganda po yan. Kasi makikita nila yung commitment mo.
At saka yung pandemic na gawa mo, di ba?
Yes, correct po. And then, probably close strongly by... Kumbaga, mag-iwan ka po ng one declaration or one sentence na parang sinasabi niyo po dun sa recruiter na, and this is the reason why I want, kumbaga, to be considered in your company. So, yan.
Paano naman yung, kung ito kasi, one of the top 10 questions ito na tricky talaga, Rod, no? Why should we hire you and not them? Tuturo pa
correct,
not them.
Correct.
So, ano yan? Ano ang tamang sagot niyan?
Okay, so ang key po, again, is to understand what they are looking for.
Mm-hmm,
yan.
Okay.
So, in terms of Kasi nakalagay po dyan eh, yung sa minimum requirements. No. Ibig sabihin, pag sinabi nilang must have, meaning non-negotiable.
No.
So might as well, make sure po na pag sinagot nyo yung tanong na why should we hire you, eh matik nyo po lahat nung hinahanap
yung
nila.
Yung qualifications talaga na gusto nila.
Exactly. Mm. So pag po kasi na-pinpoint nyo yun, eh parang nyo nang chinek yung lahat nung kanilang
yung checklist
diba?
Na. Oh,
exactly.
Ito.
So hired na to.
Hired
so,
na.
Kailangan po, you know the kumbaga requirements and then sell it to them why you meet, if you meet all those requirements, then I don't think, you know, maiisip nila na, ah, hindi to qualified.
Mm.
Especially if you're able to highlight na nagawa mo na yun.
Mm.
So, yun po yung
at saka, dapat talaga you focus on your own accomplishment kasi hindi mo naman alam mo yung kakayahan ng iba eh.
Exactly po. Exactly.
You don't know that they're even more qualified than you.
True. And also, napaka-importante po yung confidence.
Yan, confidence talaga.
Yes,
oo.
Yes.
Gusto ko pong pasalamatan yung lahat na nanonood sa atin. Ibahagi natin yung learnings natin na ito by sharing our live segment. Sino po ba ang may greetings dyan? No, ipakita nga natin para... Dom Ricky Vicente Sheila, good afternoon po. I'm watching from La Union.
Hello,
Isabella.
Po.
Magandang hapon. Edwin Neguzuan, watching from the Rumbang, Rizal. Okay, sino pa ba? Good job! Marami kang fans dito, Rod. Sino pa ba? Regina Sula is watching. Great tips.
Hello.
And insights. Pag-T-bone talaga. Maraming tayong mga informative segment. Meron tayong mga short films with lessons in life. No? Sino pa ba? Di kompleto ang araw ko pag di makasubaybay ng T-bone. No? Thelma Adele! Sino pa ba? Bebing Barciliano. Good be watching from Isulan, Sultan Kudarat.
Wow.
Luzon,
po.
Visayas, and Mindanao tayo. Barangay Hall, si Barangay Chairman, nagpaparamdam.
Ito
talaga, no, every week, kasabi nga ng wife ko, believe ako, nagtatrabaho pa kaya si Barangay Chairman at saka si Barangay Tanod, no? Paragi na lang, gusto ko palang pasalamatan, ha, for sharing, Ekay Babala, Ronald Orlando from from Bahrain, Desa Casinelia from Kuwait, Jimil Almadhun from Saudi Arabia, Donatan Romy from Qatar, Alvin Pancito from Dubai, Leo Manyala from Dubai, Elisa Manyala, sikat na singer ito, Elisa Manalang, Delmar Yambao, Max Arte from the Philippines, Elton Bautista, Michelle Minor, ito yung magaling din, Acer Banson, Lord Jillian Palma, Nora Manligis, Arlene Litran, Emil Garcia, Annalyn Alaras, Irene Mahilom, Jewel Pencil, Madeline Lunita, and Francis Haranilla. Maraming salamat for sharing our weekly live podcast. Tapos na tayo, no, sa isang question. Ito, kasi karamihan talaga pumalpak nito, no. Ito yung magbibigay sa nag-interview kung anong klaseng tao ka. How would your manager describe you? O anong magandang sagot niyan?
Ayan.
Sampulan mo nga, Rod, kung paano.
Yes. Okay, so let's say for example, ako po yung tinanong. Ako yung tinanong, how would your manager describe you? My manager would describe me as someone who is very reliable,
okay,
committed to excellence, delivering results, and making sure that whatever I do is nothing but excellent.
Yeah.
So, and these are actual comments that I received from my manager from my performance reviews. So, importante po na i-recall natin yon. Yan. And then, of course, like I said, kailangan po maging honest din tayo, di ba? We cannot exaggerate. Hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na mas magaling pa ako sa manager ko, di ba? So, let's always make sure that it's something that your manager actually gave you as a feedback. Kasi they would come back po for a reference check.
Yun, no? Yun. Pag nagsisinungaling ka, tapos kaaway mo pala yung manager. Nako, paano yan? Oo.
So, nag-reference check po kasi.
Kung nanonood pa rin sa atin yung nag-celebrate ng birthday, yung mamo, siguro yung akong sisigaw siya, that's my daughter! Yeah!
Ayan, hello sa nanay ko.
Ito, karamihan sa mga applicant na hihirapan talaga nito, Rod, no? Why do you consider yourself the best person for the job?
Ah,
oh, paano yan sagutin? Paano?
Ayan, syempre po, like I said, no, best person, bakit mo kailangang i-sell yung sarili mo? Eh, syempre, gusto mo nga yung work, di ba? So, i-match mo. Kumbaga, etong kailangan nyo, etong meron ako. So, kailangan nyo pong iparealize dun sa hiring manager na lahat ng hinahanap nila, meron ka. And on top of that, dagdagan mo pa, di ba? So, you can show po yung, let's say for example, yung accomplishments mo, consistent. So, you assure them that you will deliver consistent results. So, kaya napaka-importante po that you understand what they are looking for. And then when you answer, you always target that. To para ma-ease po yung isip nila na, ah, okay, kaya niya to, kaya niya to, kaya niya to, kaya niya to.
No, mawala yung doubt talaga, no?
Exactly. Oh. At saka lalo po talaga pagka in your past jobs, talagang may accomplishment ka.
Oh.
So always bring that up. Huwag po kayong mahiya. Hindi po yun pagyayabang. It's just stating the fact. Tatawagin po natin siyang pagyayabang pag exagged na.
Exagged na. Tapos hindi mo kayang dipindihan, di ba?
Tama, tama.
Oh. Paano mo naman sagutin yung... why do you like to work with us?
Ayan.
Oh, bakit mo gustong magtrabaho dito?
So, yung tanong po na yan also comes back to gaano ba ka ang kaalaman mo dun sa company?
So, research talaga.
Exactly.
Is the keyword. Oh,
exactly.
Okay.
And ako po, I'm impressed with someone who relates it to our company values. So, if that person's values align to our company values, then it tells a lot about the person. So yan, maganda po yun na you really know the company and then you tell them why your personal values and your commitment to work aligns with them. Yan.
Isa sa mga questions na marami ding sumablay pag mag-guha na tayo sa salary, di ba?
Okay.
What kind of salary are you looking at? What's the right way of answering that?
Okay, ang gusto ko pong i-highlight dito is depende po kasi sa job level. Yan. So for support staff and junior staff, medyo ano po yan mahirap siyang i-evade na question. So important is you know what the market pays. Yan. So know it.
So talaga mag-research ka muna.
Opo, exactly. Let's say for example po,
waitress.
Okay.
1,002.
Okay. So bago ka pumunta dun sa interview, make sure na alam mo kung ano yung binabayad sa ibang similar class
industry,
na company.
Same industry.
Of course, hindi po tayo pwede mag-demand ng salary sa 5-star na restaurant kung ang ina-applyan natin
yung ay... Yung maliit lang, di ba?
Exactly.
Toro-toro, di ba? Street food na maliit lang.
Yes, so kailangan po maging reasonable tayo and backed by facts. Yung hihingi natin na sahod. So let's say for example for waitress Sir Rico, I don't know what the market pays, but let's say for example the market pays 1,500 and your past employer pays you 1,000. Okay? And syempre ikaw gusto mo you are paid the industry standard.
Yeah, okay.
So usually po kasi it's like again, it's a double-edged sword. If you don't answer it, some of the recruiters negative po nila yun itetake. Yung iba naman, pag in-answer mo siya in a diplomatic way, it's okay. But what I would suggest for support staff, be open and honest. How much are you expecting? And it should be a limit that you decide yourself na kumbaga ano nyo po, baseline. Na hindi ka iiyak pag binigay sa'yo at hindi ka rin naman hindi ka underpaid at hindi ka rin naman magmumukmuk pagka later on na find out mo na mas mataas pala yung binibigay nila sa iba. So it's you set it pag ganun po.
Tama ba yun, Rod, na halimbawa ito lang yung offer nila na figure, no? Tapos mag-bluff ka. No, na mayroong isang restaurant din nag-offer sa akin no na it's 100 dirhams higher, but they give me free accommodation. No, I'm actually willing to work for your company kung meron sanang ganitong package. No, so, pwede ba yung mag-bluff ka?
Actually po, hindi ako personally, I would not recommend that.
Ah, okay.
what I would suggest is negotiate it straightforward.
Okay, okay.
So let's say, for example,
how would you say it?
Sure. So let's say, for example, po, they're offering you 1,400 and you wanted 1,500, right? Because other probably companies, as you said, are offering accommodation, which helps to have the better net salary. So what I would suggest is just straightforward, negotiate it. So let's say, for example, you can feel that they're really interested in you. Sabihin nyo po na could you please review it and consider adding another 100 dirhams to your offer? Pag sinabi nila, hindi, yan lang talaga yung budget. How about if I successfully pass my probation, would you consider a salary review? That's, kumbaga, ano po yun eh, you're giving them another option. Para naman wag outright no.
I'd like to share ito. Nakakatawa eh. Meron kasi akong kilalang safety officer when we started. We actually attended the same class, no? Interview siya ng Briton. Eh, bata pa eh, no? So, masigasig siya nag-aral. So, the British was really impressed with the way he answered. Okay, I will give you 8,000 starting salary. Eh, yung bata dati, kung ano lang, nagre-repair ng mobile phone sa Karama. So, 1,500. Alam mo kung anong sagot niya? No, sir, I cannot accept that. I cannot accept that. Can you give me 6,000 first month? And then I will show you how I work. And after 3 months, if you think I'm worth my salary, give the 8,000 to me. Tumama yung Britang ginawa. At after 3 months talaga nakita kasi masigasig eh. Binigay talaga yung 8,000.
it shows po yung integrity ng
tao. Yun. Integrity, yes. Honesty. Exactly. Yun, importante yun.
Kasi nang mangyayari din po yun na if you bite more than what you can chew, di ba? So tama po yung approach na gano'n. If you're really confident that you could ask for that salary, then by all means, go for it. But always remember po, like for example, yung strategy na nagbabluff. If they tell you, then go with them. So you lost your chance already. So be honest and truthful and negotiate straightforward. Tapos pagdating naman po sa mga senior roles, normally, it's a tricky place to be. Because normally, they would tell you, please align it with the market, which usually should be the trend. So yun, kaya importante po, know what the market pays on the similar industry and similar company size. Yan, para nang sa ganun po, you are well equipped when you go to the negotiating.
Yan. Looks like we're learning a lot today. Stay where you are. Magbabalik kami for the last 3 questions when we return.
Bini sa'yo naramdaman lang bigla ng puso aking sinta, ikaw lang nagparamdam nito, kaya sabihin mo sa'kin ang tumatakbo sa isip mo. Kung mahal mo na rin ba ako, isayaw mo ko sa gitna.
Doon tayo sa elegante pero sulit. UAE Kabayan Souk.
If you are looking for a job, you have all the reasons to stay with us because you will learn a lot. Paki-share po ng live podcast natin para meron namang matutunan yung mga kaibigan natin, no? Gusto kong pasalamatan Bybet, Artalan, Ancor Rewards, and UA Kabayan Souk and Kings Medical. Yan importante yan. Ngayon, Rod, let's deal on the final 3 questions na para sa akin ay ito yung kapalpakan din ng iba, no? Kaya kung hindi talaga ready, mahihirapan, no? So, yung nabanggit mo na ito kanina eh, no? Why did you resign from your previous job? So, ano ang ideal answer to that?
Well, una po, syempre, kailangan very honest ka, but honest in a diplomatic way. Mm. So, let's take the real answers. And normally, let's say, for example po, yung for a better opportunity, that's an acceptable answer. Yeah. Because, of course, who would want to pass up a very good opportunity? So, be truthful and straightforward po. So, let's say, for example, yun yung talagang dahilan, merong better opportunity, then state it as it is. If it is because of yung boss nyo, di ba? Kumbaga, nilayasan mo nga. So, put it in a nice way wherein you could mention na it's no longer a work, healthy working relationship. So, I have decided to look for another opportunity. Mm. You don't have to be in detail and to, you know, share very negative comments about your previous employer.
Kaya nga, no thrashing of the old companies.
Yes,
or
yes.
You can be creative. Pwede ka naman ngayon nga, actually, my wife transferred to a new job location. Oh, and I have no choice except to join her and look for another place, and your company is the right company because we are just close.
Pwede ba yan? Pwede po yun. And another po, let's say for example, there's a gap in your employment wherein you either studied or helped out in the family. You can be straightforward with it without going into too much details. So let's say for example po, you took a break to study for a certain certification. That's a valid reason because it tells the employer that you're dedicated to improving yourself. Especially kung nag-masters ka or may certification ka. So just be truthful and honest. Tsaka po, brief lang talaga. Don't go too much into the personal details, especially if the reason for changing jobs is personal.
Oy, batiin mo uli yung mga dalawang HR group natin para mag-share naman sila.
Yes, so to our Phil HR professionals, hello sa inyo. And of course, the United Filipino HR professionals in the UAE.
Yan, at gusto ko rin batiin yung nag-share. Paula Vintaha, Mirasol De Claro, Visa Katrina, Ninio Alcantara, Angie Lozada, Lori Matugas, Elton Lipanta, Jeffrey Parinias, Eva Valverde, Kira Kirara, Frankie Buton, Milton Castillo, Ninia Narwane, Luciana Obihas from Jordan, Robbie Jane Valderrama, Kevin De Ocampo, Vince De La Rosa, and Rami Garcia. Thank you for always sharing. Eto, paano yung tanong na ito? Medyo mahirap ito eh. How long would it take you to contribute to our company?
Wow! Mahirap nga po yan, di ba? But I would suggest that you look into your past experience. How long did it take you para maging, kumbaga 100% productive ka? And normally po, a reasonable time is the probation period. Di po ba? It's a reasonable time, which is, I would say, 3 months. Or you can also be, what I would say is, mag-expound ka pa dun sa pag-answer mo. Like, asking them, what would you be expecting from me?
Okay.
Of course, how can you answer that question if you don't know what they're expecting of you? So let's say, for example po, for safety officer, they told you that the statistics of the company, these are the problems. So, of course, in your mind, you already have the past experience wherein you know how you will tackle the situation.
Yeah, you can incorporate that.
So, let's say, for example, I would need to do a safety audit. How long would that take? So, you can answer it in that way po. Like, for example, you know what they're experiencing now, what they're expecting of you, then lay out a short-term plan so that they would understand that, in 3 months' time, this person would have completed the short-term goals. Yan.
Alam mo yung pag establish talaga ng company, lalo na pag yung katulad mo na may HR na nag-interview with equipped with 18 years experience, di ba? Mahirap yon kasi pag magtatanong ka, halimbawa, what can you bring to the table if we will hire you? Paano yan?
No,
lalo na ikaw yung kan. So anong sagot na magpapa-impress sa'yo?
Well, ang magpapa-impress po sa akin sa sagot na yan is, una, dapat inalam nila ang dahilan bakit kami nag-hire.
Okay.
Diba? So, let's say for example, recently, we were hiring for a senior IT director. And yung IT director na yon na pinili namin, talaga na-impress po kami because he really took the time to ask questions, to understand what the situation was and the reason why we were hiring for that role. And then when we asked him, you know, what would you bring to the table? And he really captured our attention because he proposed a solution, what he will do.
Oh, okay.
To
make the situation better.
To answer the need of the company. So that's the best way that you can answer that. So let's say, for example, po, let's pick out an industry. So let's say, for example, you are a nurse. You are a nurse. And you learned that the reason why they're hiring for nurses is because the business is growing. So you can mention, you know, in my past experience, I was able to increase the productivity of the team in the if it's in the emergency you know department, and then that way they will be able to see that you are really bringing value to the company. So kailangan po talaga is you convince them with facts, not just by flowering words.
Yan last na itong tanong ko kasi ayokong tanungin yung strength kasi madali lang yan eh.
Correct.
Di ba? You can highlight your achievement, what you have, your competency. Pero ang tanong, what is your greatest weakness?
Wow, parang Superman kryptonite lang, di ba? Yan. Yan. So, actually, this question po, you should not be afraid of this question. And what I would recommend how you answer it is really pinpoint what is your weakness or area for improvement.
Okay.
Okay, you state it out there. You tell it to them. But you should follow it up with what are you doing to make sure that you improve in that area. So let's say, for example, Sir Rico, hindi ka masyadong confident magsalita presenting to other people. So you can mention that an area for improvement for me is my presentation skills with a group of people. But I'm actually working on with a coach to help me with public speaking to address this area of concern.
Yan.
So, yan.
Maganda. Or even, it's public speaking is really not my cup of tea. It's not my cup. In fact, I feel nervous when I speak in front of people. But what I'm doing now is I watch YouTube on a nightly basis before I sleep. And I actually joined a Toastmasters club.
Wow.
Oh, di ba?
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
So pwede 'yon.
Yes, tama po 'yon. So it's kasi mahirap din po, may na-interview ako, Sir Rico, wala siyang weakness. di ba? Parang sabi ko, ano to, Superman nga, may kryptonite, di ba?
Baka sabihin niya na, lalaki, what is your weakness? Girls, mom.
Huwag naman ganon. So something professionally related.
Oh, yeah. Dapat hindi personal, ha?
Yes. Oh, baka naman mamaya mga ganun. Dapat wag ganun. So I always answer professionally. And like I said, even though you say your weakness, make sure that you also tell them what you are doing to strengthen the weakness.
To convert it into strength.
Exactly.
Diba?
Yun.
Last batch sa nag-share, salamatan ko. Malu Mahartin, Christina Siete Reales, Oliver Revilla from Qatar, Joan Vargas, Hale Kalalo, Joy Ann Mangulabnan, Marie-Chris Gapi, Sharon Rivera, Maribel Doctolero, Janet Canlas, Tim San Andres, Cathy Cadiz, Kim Manalansan, and Ren Manalansan. Maraming salamat for supporting our cause of sharing tips and insight to those who are watching us.
Yes.
3.9 million followers of T-Bone. Maraming salamat. Paki-share po. Ngayon, anong final tips ang maibigay mo before we finally wind up, Rod?
Sure. Para po sa mga naghahanap ng trabaho, of course, preparation is really key. So let's start with having a well-written CV. Okay, so pwede nyo pong balikan yung ating tips on how to do a well-written CV. And then, pag po tinawag na kayo for interview, make sure that you are also very well prepared, okay?
Ay, teka muna, nakalimutan ako. Ang ideal ba yung pagkatapos ng interview dahil hindi ka tinawagan, ikaw yung tatawag?
Okay lang po mag-follow up, but give them the right amount of time.
Ah, okay.
Yes, so let's say for example, after your interview, you've not heard from them, let's say 2 to 3 days, it's okay to follow up with an email or a phone call to the person who contacted you. Now, if they don't get back to you, let's say, for example, they told you, okay, we'll get back to you in a week, then mark your calendar. If they miss that deadline, it's okay to follow up again, but don't do it too aggressively. Yes, otherwise it will turn off the employer.
Okay, so ano pa bang tip ang maibigay mo, Rod?
Yes, so tulad po nabanggit ko, so well-written CV, you should have that. Second is you should be very well prepared when you are being called for the interview. So make sure that you are confident, you present yourself very well, without being too arrogant or exaggerating on your CV. So it's, you know, they will feel it. They know if you are what we call overpadding your accomplishments. Ayan, they can always check. So don't lie. And of course, be very truthful, honest, and candid about, you know, the questions that are being asked to you. And at the end of the day, it's all about making sure that the jobs that you apply for really match, you know, the qualifications, the experiences that you have. Otherwise, your CV will just go to the trash.
Yes. Ayan. Sigurado ako, kung nanonood po kayo ngayon, ay malaking tulong itong discussion natin. Especially, we are listening to a competent HR professional. Rod, maraming salamat for your time.
Ano man.
Pasensya na. Alam ko, alis ka papuntang Africa tomorrow and you're supposed to prepare things. Pero with your commitment to serve the Filipino community anywhere in the world, andito ka. So, in behalf of Direct Mike Nerpiol, I'd like to sincerely thank you for being part of this episode. And as a gesture of my thanks, I'm giving you a free copy of my book, The 12 Habits of Highly Successful OFWs.
Thank you po, Sir Rico. Salamat po sa
For those who are watching us, maraming salamat for being part of Episode 7 of Standing Out, Speaking Out. Kaya nga, we always end by saying, why blend when you can stand out?
Yeah.
Why fit in when you can stand out? Diba?
Exactly.
Ipakita natin ang galing ng Pinoy. Let's create a better version of ourselves. Maraming salamat! And keep safe always sa ating mga sponsors. Maraming salamat po. Without you, this podcast will never be a reality. Keep safe always!